just wanted to walk the yard a little quick second here and see what's cracking. Looks like people have been back, which is good to see because this place needs to be painted on the regular. But now, let's get to something very special. Don't you love it though? Look at this. Like the buff man went over my shit. He left me hanging out halfway. Then some kid did a throw up, and then some kid did a piece. It's like the beautiful anarchy of graffiti. That's, for me, that is what makes graffiti very interesting. The beautiful anarchy of it. And yeah, there are some rules or norms, I guess you should say, in the graffiti world. But to see the alphabet soup start to mix up and kind of become an organism in itself is kind of wild. So I guess I got a war to fight, don't I, with the buff man. So we gotta tag this, right? We gotta do something. I gotta say something to this guy. So what are we gonna do? I think I have an idea. Yo, check out this bandana. My wife got it for me on Etsy a few years back. Check out this kid. Isn't he a little shit? So I painted him a few years back on another wall that I did, but I moved too far away from that wall to maintain it anymore. But I live close to this one, and nobody's doing anything. Although Voorhees came by, I saw that big spud in the house. Big ups. But this needs to be handled, son. We need to do something about that. We gotta free the walls. We gotta liberate. If you wanna liberate anything in your life, liberate the walls. So let's get cracking. All right, it's really windy and super noisy from that machine over there. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put on some tunes and get painting. And then when we're done, we'll do a quick wrap up. All right, I'll see you guys in a second. All right, sick, I got my outline in, so I think I'm gonna do a shirt. And for a shirt color, I'm gonna use the aqua. No, I know it's not a new color, but I really like the aqua, and it's a great color for his shirt. So, fuck the haters. All right, sick, so I got the traffic purple. I'm gonna do his hat and his shorts with that color. This spot is not legal, but it's kind of chill. Still got to keep an eye out. So I got his hat and his other shit done in. Look how close I am to the road. Can you see that over there? I don't know if you can see trucks and shit coming, but I'm hella close to the road. All right, so I got his hat and stuff in. I'm gonna use that politically incorrect color for his skin. Look, he's a white kid. All right, sick, so we went ahead and did the fill with this fleshlight, and it takes a couple coats to make it really cover, and I wasn't surprised about that. Just didn't cover, baby. The white don't fill, and black don't crack. All right, sick, so it's time to do the skateboard, so I brought some cacao green. I thought cacao green would be a good choice. What do you guys think? I think cacao green is an excellent choice for the skateboard. Are you guys seeing what I'm painting over here? I can't really see the screen. Yeah, you can see. You guys can see it. All right, sick. Do you see the wind blowing everything I'm painting the other direction? Good grief. If it's not fucking rainy, it's fucking windy in this town. It's like, if it's not fucking windy, it's hailing or some other shit. I'm telling you, I gotta test this shit in the worst environments. I know my homies in Iceland are like, oh, come on now, come down to Reykjavik. I've been to Reykjavik. I had some Icelandic horse sashimi. It was quite delicious. Now that was some tactical snacking. Sick, we got the skateboard filled in. Let's do the wheels. Either way, this yellow covers good. This is zinc yellow in the flame orange, and I gotta tell you, it actually covers better than that Rusta we were using the other day. No, you're just trying to shill. No, do it side by side. I think this does pretty damn good, especially with a nice cap on it. It's excellent. So we got the wheels colored in. We got his skin color colored in. I think it's time to lace everything in black. All right, cool. He's doing a throwy, nice and grimy style too. That's what we're looking for. All right, let's go ahead and start outlining this bad boy. Get him done, son. I gotta move on to the next video, baby. Dude, there's so many cars going by right now. But you know, such is life. There's a little retard right now. There we go. One little bad boy in the club. He got in a bit of a scuffle, obviously. It's a little swollen, but that's okay. All right, so I was just about to leave the spot, and I see my dude Klepto has blessed us with his presence, and his homie, let's say Tracy? Didn't quite catch that. Sorry, Tracy. Frank. Oh, Big Forge in the house. I can read that one. An Acer. Big Acer. I had an Acer computer once. Those are good computers. Well, they used to be. Back in the day. I don't know about anymore. But, you know, it's good to see the kids out. Active. Getting shit done. But this wall is not being utilized properly. It's a space that has become poorly managed, really. I mean, that's what the bottom line is. It should be a free wall, a place for people to paint. And that's my mission, to make it such. Let's go find some other spots. Check out this spot, the Hobo Hideout. When you need to get some fresh water in the house. I feel that. Holy moly. Terrain is rough, son. This is not the America I signed up for. Although I do appreciate the anarchy. I do. I definitely appreciate the anarchy aspect of it. All right, sick. I got some zinc yellow right now, and I'm gonna do a quick little coverage test. This wall's already covered with tags. There's garbage everywhere. There's definitely needles on the ground. It seems that Seattle doesn't really give a shit. So I'm gonna do a throwy on this. Utilize the marginal areas. The Rusto that I tried earlier, it covers just as good, if not better, but it smells way less. It smells way less than the Rusto. Also, it comes out much faster with the fatter spray. Gotta like it. Let me go ahead and do a splash and cover all the back. Thank you. was eating the black a little bit. It's a little bit wet still. I had to do an extra thick coat to make a cover. I probably should make the R a little bit thicker like the rest of the letters, but we'll do that later. It don't matter. We're just here fucking around, getting up, walking the jungle. Seen the sights of the city. Not everything is so pretty. Well, that was quite a little adventure, but it was a lot of fun. I'm glad we got to get out today. Yeah, we had a chance to use a lot of great colors today, and it was good to get out, get on the street, and do a little doodle here and there. I mean, if you're not doodling, what are you doing? Right? You got to do the craft. When you fell off the tricycle, you got to get right back on it. You know, and it's a lot like riding a bike. You know, you can stop doing graffiti, and I've talked to a lot of people who's like, oh, I stopped doing graffiti, but I've been watching your videos, and now I want to paint again. And to me, that's like really powerful, man. Like, I had a guy call me, he's like, I love your videos, thank you so much, you've changed my life. And I was like, I've never had people talk to me that way before, so it was like really heavy, and I was like, whoa, bro, you know, like, I appreciate it. But I'm learning to understand that, you know, and I do appreciate that. I'm glad that I'm helping getting you guys motivated and getting out there, you know, because, you know, it's got one life. You got to get out there and paint, man. You got to do it. If you're a graffiti writer or an artist or whatever it is that you do, you got to do the do, right? You got to get out and paint something. But anyways, oh, and someone was asking about whether what I was doing was illegal. And in my videos, I do like to skirt that line a little bit. But you'll probably never see me doing like fill-ins on the side of a Walgreens or something. You know what I mean? I'm not going to be able to condone that in my position. I hope you guys understand that. But, you know, I want to go paint spots and do pieces. You know, the graffiti art, that's still just as much graffiti, you know? And there's so many marginal places in the city that are just being left to rot. You know, and why not occupy that with artists who are, you know, is that really the worst thing you can do in these areas, is do some graffiti? Especially when no one's really occupying them anyways. You know, I mean, there's like the Dookie Wall. Nobody, even the bums don't live there. Well, they poop there. That's why it's called the Dookie Yard. You know, it's an untapped resource, right? You know, let's use these untapped resources. Let's Burnside these spots. All right, six. So for the character we did, the skateboard, first I did the board itself with Cacao 77 Green. And if you haven't used this color, it's fantastic. Actually, if you're into cars and you like to paint like your valve covers and things like that, get this color. It looks filthy in a car engine. Highly recommend it. Zinc yellow, of course, in the flame orange. I did the skateboard wheels and the throwy with this. This cover is just like the Rusto. Definitely check it out, but you get the filthy flares with it. Gorgeous stuff. Big, big fan of this can. Let's see, of course I used the aqua light again. I forgot what, I think I did a shirt with that color. Of course, for the hat and his pants, I used the classic Signal Purple. Now this color is available in a lot of different paint lines. So if you go into like German Montana, Spanish Montana, it's highly likely they have this color. In fact, I think it's an old Rao color, like one of those universal colors, kind of like Pantone or whatever. Someone correct me if I'm wrong on that one. You know, I'm just talking out of my ass, based off of some experience, of course, obviously. But this color is, oh, it's so gorgeous. But you can use them pretty much anything. Did it with the hat and stuff. Can't go wrong with that. And then, of course, I used the raisin, or what's it called? Grape. In German, it's raisin. I'm using this on everything these days. It's one of my favorite colors. You've probably seen it before, so we'll just move on. Oh, last but not least, the wonderfully politically incorrect titled Skin Light. Look at that, Skin Light. I'm sure they didn't mean anything by it, so don't no one get triggered, please. I'm sure it was just a translation issue. If you really want to get offended, go look up Mr. Black Ink. Go on, go Google it. Oh, Italy, you guys are so rude, but I love you. I love you, Italy, it's a great country. But anyways, so, you know, just a bunch of colors I used. Of course I love the paint, duh. But it's good to see how the colors look, right? I mean, that was a lot of fun. And then I used the Signal Black and the white. White. I like to say that. I used Signal Black and the white. I gotta get to keep a straight face when I say that. And to the kid on Instagram who asked if he could remove eggshell from his mom's car, I haven't tried it. I'm not in the business of removing things, so I don't know. I would suggest maybe using a plastic razor blade and maybe moving a little bit further away from your house to apply those. Maybe 6 blocks radius would be good. That's what I would recommend. And your mom already knows. Don't tell your mom. No. Keep your mouth shut. Unless you're a street artist. Tell your mom you're a street artist. That's what you do. Tell you're a street artist, and then keep the graffiti stuff to yourself. Mass murderer mentality. So, is that creepy? All right. I love you guys. It's fantastic talking to you again. I want you all to go out there and paint this weekend. I love all the pictures you're sending me. I'm gonna definitely be doing another one of those picture blasts. So, don't worry if you haven't seen your image up. Well, you might not get picked. So that's the way life goes sometimes. You know, life isn't fair. But I'm very fair in who I pick. I don't try to pick all the people who think they're super tight. I like the kids. The kids are our future, man. We gotta raise them right, son. Anyways, it's been a pleasure. Art Primo, GR Reviews. Oh, don't forget, give us a call, 206-365-4083. Again, 206-365-4083. That's artprimo.com. We're your number one source for all your graffiti supplies, everything. We got bulk pricing for mirrorless. We got the biggest selection of markers you've ever seen. I mean, bro, check out our marker section. We beat everybody. And for small orders, shipping's only $4.99. So if you want to get a grip of markers, it's usually not that much to ship. Now, paint's different, and some people have some questions about that, and I think they're very valid. The thing with paint is it's flammable and it's pressurized, which I'm sure you know that. So it has to go by ground. And I know there's some companies that don't do that. We try to keep everything on the level because we want to be able to ship. You know, we don't want to get our Primo shut down. So we do have to do it that way. Keep in mind, though, the more you order, the cheaper it is, the shipping. So we're more than happy to work with you on that. So if you have any questions, I'd say bulk orders are the best way. We got free shipping on orders over $75. So, you know, if you can't do that, get with your homie. I have a lot of customers that do that. There'll be like 2 or 3 dudes, you know, and they get together and they order a rack of paint. It's not so bad on $75. You know, between 3 people, $25 a piece, right? Anyways, thank you very much, guys. It's been a pleasure. I'll see you later.